So last night I was working on templates for some point cloud generators. A little bit of implementation, but not much. Today I want to finish these. So let's see. Point cloud. So we have a variety of different implementations of the point cloud generator that we want to deal with here. I've already added their public values. We'll need to set defaults and whatnot. But we're going to start working on these generate point cloud internal methods. So I'm actually going to start here because this is the most complicated one. And after this one's done, the rest should kind of fall like dominoes. So, what's that mean? Well, we want to go right here. All right, so first of all, let's get some default values in there, right? Six times three is 18,000. All right, so back over here. Actually, we wanted this one. All right, so B. We set our TFO values from this thing over here. Create some bounds for these. All right, so we got all our basic stuff. Now we need to go implement our point cloud generation function, which is going to be here. There's our random stream. Right, so we can just leave the random stream for later. Points divided by
Literally just like this weird space that it's good, but it's actually like a
Okay.
good thing for awareness because if your brain really wants that kind of environment, yeah, being super flexible. Then you're like, maybe you're wrong and you're like, you're the beta.
The increment.
Risk is restricted with your brain for anything, but the risk you can say, sure, other people do it too, but it's still a risk. But if you say maybe,
Double
the stepping up is that if you do
two
that,
pi equals two times
you
math dot.
every single step is
How do I get pi in C++?
that you thought of it, and you used the error code that you thought of. Literally, the code that I thought of was like this code that I thought of that was like this code that I thought of. Really difficult to do, but then how to go safe in the science. Do you make room to do AI? How do you like encourage QA that you have today to also learn the math a lot of that, but basically in the realm of automation? Make sure you like give them the leftovers so we have space for the brain. Yeah, if I had more people on here, if I had a need of more like a QA
That
team,
seems like a terrible idea. Then you're calculating pi every time you need it. St here we go. This is what we want. This is what we want.
because they have a really good structure for it.
Include numbers. It's the new encyclopedia of numbers.
I think you're right, but I always forget there's stuff called numeric forces in math that you can add to the numbers. So we can actually
Oops.
You lose that space to do a very debate, probability
Okay,
game,
two pi.
and to do
Oops.
exponential stuff. That is amazing. So anything good for your
So
QA
far, so good.
or you could basically start QA doing that for you. And then ask them to do that for you.
Double. Two pi divided by.
Generate the number that means something. Yet it showed me very quickly that this works because Amazon has a business and they own a data warehouse. Yet this
Temp points
is a squeezer against
per
this
arm.
space. The
There we
power
go.
of saying it is urgent, and of course Amazon is not urgent. And it just grabs them. Which is the best? The people that have priority, they already in the first step, but before they don't have that's good. What are you going to end up doing in like 15, 15 years if you got fired? What are you going to get back? Yeah, thank you. So just write your name. Your work comes back to you. It was
F
magic.
vector min bounds equals
Since that we're losing that image that humans have of Amazon. And it's so devastating because I can understand, oh, we make it as a business, but I think the goal is a product. Yeah. Names are your thing. Names, you have a name of a team, you've got a name. That makes sense. That means somebody was using that name. That's the unbanned name that you can't get it back. And that's why you see so many of these other studios. Like, if you look at Amazon Mouse, like Mouse is using good Amazon. Mouse is using Google Play.
set
Even Google Play
F
itself is using
vector.
Google Play. There's so many of us. We want to inherit all of this basic stuff. But the best thing for it is also to get all of that information. Wouldn't be that great if you from the design second bit exposed to him, nervous. That's why nervous and before you get so up. Because he loves programs. And now first time he's in a stable life with a brain drill, right? And it shows really quickly that when that passion leaves, you still got the name, but you don't got the brain. And that's Well, Simon, when they had on the Zip reporting, I think that's on there when they took people really play the game well. You can see that they're disconnected, but you can also see that with everything. Obviously, they produce that game. He's not the game that he was like. And I guess it's like that is all the way that the game he always wishing. You know, or I mean, technically, it's not social. You know, like, still all the way back, but
There we go. Okay. I have to make this rotator. This random stream, random There it is. There we go. There we go. God damn it. God damn it. All right. There. All right. That's our rotator values. C plus plus for UE5. How can I make a rotator for 3x, x, y, z? F rotator. Beautiful. All right. Oops. There we go, and get some nice camo case going on. There we go. All right, now we got our rotator. Okay, we don't use that for a while. Okay, looks good, looks good. Outer loop. I'm multiplying by pi here. A. So auto A pi equals standard numbers pi times this A. Beautiful. All right, there we go. By, or zero, I less than temp arm count and then in here we're gonna a pi divided by temp arm count times I. Set. All right, temporary th t theta. Temp theta offset. Okay. Yeah, I divided by temp. This is temp theta's offset gets set. Okay, next. Temp arm transform set equals false. Okay. Now we have another for loop. Is this constructed 0 to points per arm? So then 10 points per arm.
They're like, oh, no. Hey, let's like get you your payout. Let's do all these things. I know how this works like that, but I've got no.
Okay, looks good. And then inside here, TB. 10B was set there. Okay. I may need these as temporary values, so we'll do this here. Set TA. Temp A, temp B. Temp A is 1, temp B is B. Okay. Okay, initialize these. I don't know, that's wrong. Temp B equals this B. Yep, all right. Okay, so now we have these set. We can come back over here, right here. Okay, iteration radius. Here we go. So we're gonna do so in this next for loop, temp B times temp theta times temp A set temp R. TR. We set the output of that into TR. Then we come down here and we have some calculations. We're going to make a T vector XYZ. Put this over here. Get this, fuck. Come on. There it is. We probably won't need this for the moment. That's a little bit easier to work with. Now we have T theta times T theta offset. Where did I set T theta? Okay, we set that back here. Okay, here we go. So
Or if I'm sorry if you're So there's obviously something, there's been values or something like that, but you still
And
have to do something.
combined theta equals temp theta plus temp theta offset. And then auto TX equals temp R times cosine of temp combined theta TY equals temp R times sine of temp combined theta. So we've got TZ Z variance times negative one this random stream F Oops. Okay, that's our Z variance value. Okay, cool. And then this random stream F rand. This is to the power of Jesus Christ. What is this connected to? Z variance fall off. Okay. Auto TZ equals. This value, the power of the Z variance fall off. Z rand, Z variance fall off. times. Z jitter. All right, so we have our first point generated here. All right, and then Jesus Christ. Okay, so now we need an if. We set t vector here. Okay. So then this comes down into an if t arm form set if true. Okay, so we need a temp, a T arm transform. So if it's true, we simply T arm transformers. We simply add these two. And then we're just gonna T vector equals this. T vector times shift arms towards center. This shift arms toward center. It's 0 minus this, and then temp arm transform equals this.
So my for that, my grandma would do that. So what you do is you get the back first. You can, you know, you do the same about CS for that if you ever done. And you actually go down in the trenches and be there down for like 24 hours or 72 hours. And this comes out of. And I figure out that this doesn't make any sense. Makes sense. And it would be done so about CS and we've done the back for like months, 1 month. I don't feel like that for a day. That's what I'm going to get back down for that. This is in a good script and stuff. Yeah. And it's sad that you didn't know any of these things like that. It's better than, yeah, 5,000 person, but they have to use maximum inclusive.
How do I do this? Okay, so bullshit. Okay. All right, that works. Oh God, here we go. It's not so bad. You just have to kind of untangle what's going on here, because this is more complicated than you would think, because it's specifically because it's in blueprints, and this is also not connected. So we should be safe to delete this. That gets rid of these, it clears that up a little bit. This is not being used. All right, here we go. T, X, Y variance. So this is our vector as it stands, but we have to modify it with our jitter, is what's going on here. And then we also need to go ahead and have a vector array because we're getting ready to add our first one. So vector array. Turn points. No, it's not like that. This is going to be like fall off, so you need a point random float from stream. Oh, We'll call this auto XY print equals this random stream F rand. This XY variance fall off, I bet. And then auto XY jitter equals. This X Y variance times 0.5 and then the multiply these two. This random stream F rand range XY jitter times -1 XY jitter auto All right, so now we have them combined together, which we see right here. We have to do it twice. Equals okay, we combine them. We don't have to do it like this here. And then we add them and we jam it in the array, right? So now we have T vector auto final vec vector equals. Yeah. T vector plus XY offset. And then we just free rotated points dot add final vector. All right, beautiful. Now we have all of this done, which is most of it. All right, and then we also have to do this little dance here. There it is. Min bounds equals factor. Min bounds x final vector x This maintains our min and max values. Okay, that covers all of this. Oh, and then finally, this part's very important. Actually, gonna do it before this. All right, so T theta, temp theta. Equals temp theta plus temp increment. Okay, so this covers this case. All right, and the last part is us applying a rotational transform to all the points. Okay, so we're actually pretty close here. Let's save this bad boy. Oops. No, go away. Yo-yo. All right, so now, this is the outside of the outer loop. So once this is done, we have one more loop. For in I equals 0, I is less than. Okay, there we go. Okay, yeah, we're normalizing it, and then we're rotating it. Okay. Yeah, we can do this. So, got our generated points here. We need to. We have their T max and T min for the. Okay, so. So we have. T ranges equals
They're put me on a business list to work anywhere else, so they activated an incomplete purpose and restricted me from working anywhere I have agreements. And you may like your favorite before, so this is a good agreement, right? You can't stop someone from working at all if it's a good
E ranges, where'd my bounds go? Min and max bounds. So it's max bounds minus min bounds. Rotated points. I minus T and max bounds. Minus min bounds, actually. Try to be precise in these because if we mess it up, it's going to be a pain to figure out where. All right, so from the array element, we subtract the min bounds. We subtract the min bounds from the max bounds. We divide this by this. This. Effector, this is going to be You're unnormalizing it, so point vector point T point times two minus one. Yeah, we can actually. Okay, I see. So we've already generated it with the Z on the correct axis. So now we need to. All right, norm point equals norm point x, norm point dot y. Pre-rotated point. Okay. So you're going to need a normalized points array as well. Okay. Normalized points dot All right, we have one more loop to process here. This one shouldn't be too bad. Right, so finally, or it's less than normalized points length num office plus. Individuals that I Okay, how can I rotate? What is the equivalent C++ to print vector function? F vector rotate angle axis. Axis. Normalized points by rotator.
System that you know how to fix. That's why I do that today. Because it goes type server. Yet the click lines, if you need a good person that is both engaged with the company and empowered to solve problems to be in that kind of a position. And once they are, they can rip right through that virtual and just remove it. It's like brain assist. That's all it is.
But yeah, one last one of this, and I think this one's very sweet ending for this.
What? I don't think that's right. Rotate vector. Okay. Was points I rotate what? Rotate vector. Ah, I see. And then finally, we've got turn points dot add the rotated final point. Now, I'm sure we can probably optimize this, but it's still okay, I think. All right, now we need. Okay, so now we should have our point cloud generator, but we're going to need a way. Okay, Let's talk about the next step here. There is a header for a generator I just made. How can I instantiate blueprint? Okay, that's fine. We don't have to do that right now. It's current
something goes wrong, then it's going to harm the company because somebody's found that employee. Could be legally problematic. I think a lot of people forget that. It's not a HR family, HR family. It's not a family. We're human beings as well. That's not for laws to protect the company. Mistakes, whatever. Mistakes are the core problems that they can get into with viewpoints. There are some, I mean, to be fully fair, there are some problems with employees. And you have to be fair there.
Let's see. So we grab this. Okay, let's try it. Let's see if it worked. Do I get pi and UE5s?
Something better can happen. That's a good thing. But I'm going to go out of job. I think it's a good thing. There's no assurance that I talked to, like, maybe that was.
Try it again. Okay, it built. What do we call this static method? I'm thinking that this might should be a part of the interface. But let's just do create spiral instance. Luckily, this is by far the most complicated one of these, so once we got this one working. Okay, and then okay, we can set values. Great. And then generate point cloud. New property blueprint callable. Compilation error. What? Bullshit. What? A broadcaster. Why is this upset? Maybe it's just not happy about me implementing it in the header. Delete this. Delete this. Shift tab. Build. Oh, not happy. A dingus. And yeah, we're going to expose all this stuff. Here. So theoretically, this little block right here. Open the level blueprint. Let's do a test real quick. It's not pretty, but it should be sufficient to test. And then No. Delete. Don't like it like that. Delete this. God damn it. Delete. Matching event. Here we go. Clean stream. None. Breakpoint right here. Let's give it a shot. Maybe. It doesn't lock up like it might be doing right now. That works. That one doesn't. We're locked up. All right. So bring it down. Start it up. What's broken? All right, and I think I'll go ahead and do a pre-dinner burn. I actually need to make some dinner here in a minute, so it probably won't be on too much longer. But I think, like, it's not polished yet, but like, this is the one that was kind of the boogeyman for me, that was like blocking me from doing the other ones, because it's like I knew it was going to be a pain in the ass to sort through it. It was messy. I think it can be cleaned up quite a bit. However, the other ones are pretty simple. So assuming we can get this one working correctly, we'd be in a really good spot for the rest of them later tonight after I eat dinner. I may or may not stream it, but so this is all kind of in pursuit of the next steps. Like, we have our procedural planet now. We have our octree, our sparse voxel octree for like placing things in very large amounts of space. Right now all my point clouds are synchronous because I wrote them quickly in blueprints, so I'm converting those. But the fun part of it is not this. The fun part is once these are done, we actually get to start putting all the bits and pieces that I've built together to try and do something like make a procedural solar system, and then make a procedural galaxy, and then make a procedural universe. We have all the pieces now. I have to figure out the math for the way I want to do the coordinate system, because there's going to be some pretty complicated stuff going on for like, you can't represent a universe in the coordinates even with doubles, right? It's not possible. So what you can do is you can make it like your galaxy particle system and your star system particle systems can be a similar size to your solar system particle system. But you have to basically treadmill them in the opposite direction of the player that the player's moving for whenever the player moves any. And that will make it feel like they're bigger. So imagine you make something 10 times bigger, then everything is 10 times further away and everything takes 10 times longer to get there. Or you can make it so that when you're moving towards that thing, it's moving away from you at a rate 9 out of 10 times the speed that you're moving. So, like 9 tenths of the speed you're moving, it's moving away from you in the same direction. That means it still takes you 10 times the amount of time to get there, but the thing can be smaller and have like precision. So, we got to figure out the math for that. But the key to that is basically what we're doing right now. Getting these point cloud systems working so that we can go in and start creating some like robust proceduralization harnesses for this stuff. So let's go back over here, open the level blueprint. Hopefully it saved it. Hopefully it didn't, but we can rebuild it. set num points. Okay, great. There we go. Beautiful. Down here. And then finally, generate point cloud. Here. And string. Num. Toggle a breakpoint here. Let's save it. Point cloud testing. I thought I just did that. Test. Save. Yes. What? The fuck is wrong with that? Weird. Very weird. We may just make this an actor. Okay, this makes more sense. So let's save everything. File, save all. Spiral point cloud. No, no, no. That's the one we've got already. Spiral instance. Okay. Set num points. 1800. We'll just do 1800 this time. We may need, like, let's do it like this. Okay. There we go. Compile. Save. We can play. Compile. Save. Everybody's happy. Alright. Set. Stream. Stream for now. Okay. Next. Bind. Custom event. Okay. Has Dilger function changed? No. I don't actually know why this is happening. Create event signature function event create delegate proxy function does not match necessary sig. All right, so I'm gonna hang on. Let's delete these. Copy this, just like lift it up. Blueprints. Here is the error message I'm getting, and here is the
Right.
The reference, okay. I see. Okay, that's probably it. Got it. All right, so save it, file, save all, save everything. Okay, there we go. Go over here, set a breakpoint here, set a breakpoint here. We got nothing back, so now we have to debug the C++. Okay, we need U properties on all this shit. All right, let's see what the settings are being set to on the point cloud generator. Should be okay. But we get nothing back. All right, so let's run our you can start with Okay, so now I think what we gotta do is go in here and step through this stud. Alright, here we go. Wait, what?
About farming, do you? But first off, we gotta get the clock around because, so T-Bone's in the school. We have to just snap stuff off since he's out. Oh, fuck, that's right.
I see the problem. Derpy derp derp. Go. 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 We got it. All right. I think we got it. Now we're gonna need to visualize these. Well, they're certainly like pseudo random, so that's good. So now, here's a big question. Now that it's async, what kind of time frame are we looking at? Toggle breakpoint. We don't need this one. All right. Ready, set, go. Pretty fast. That's pretty fast. All right. Great. So now, okay. Cool. That is great. So there's one. Let's stress test. That's pretty good still. All right. 1.8 million. Okay, there was a noticeable delay that time. 180 million. It works. I think it works. All right, so we'll have to hook it up to a visualization harness here in a second. All right, how about 1.8 billion? So, yeah, 1.8 billion is pushing it. It managed to do it. So, you're telling me this fucking array is 1.8 billion entries? Holy shit. That's crazy. You wouldn't need that many. A million would be plenty. A million would be absolutely plenty. I may have actually just locked it up by trying to mess over that. But that's okay, because I think our function's working now. At least it gives the appearance of working. We won't know for sure until I hook up a visualization harness for it, but I need to get some dinner. So I'm gonna bail for now and probably hit this a little bit later tonight. Later. See ya.